from That's Le Plan, and I'm coming to you today to talk to you all about how you can get to Le Plan for your summer holiday or for your next ski holiday. So we're going to cover all sorts of things, from how to get to Le Plan, flying to Le Plan, how to take the train, airport transfers, driving to Le Plan, and also how to travel with your ski and snowboard bags. And I'm going to throw in as many top tips and things as I can. So this is going to be a general overall video, and then what you'll find is on my channel lots of other videos with more specific information about all those different ways of traveling to Le Plan. So there's lots of things that you need to consider when you're thinking about how to travel to your ski holiday, whether it's to Le Plan or whether it's to another ski resort. But it's things like, are you traveling on a peak day, which tends to be the weekends and specifically Saturdays? Are you traveling with family and children? Are you traveling in peak season? So again, that tends to be the kids' summer holidays. There's lots of things to think about. Are you looking for like more sustainable travel options? There's lots of things that kind of you need to take into your consideration. So we're going to go through all of those for you. So firstly, if you are looking to come to Le Plan, which is the resort that I live in, and that's what a lot of this channel is about, it's a pretty accessible ski resort. We are about 3 hours, 3.5 hours away from main airports, which are Geneva, Grenoble and Lyon, which we'll talk about in a minute. And flying to the Alps or to the Tarentaise Valley here, where Le Plan is one of the most popular ways of getting to a ski holiday. But it's not the only way. There are other options that are becoming more and more popular over the past few years. So let's have a look at the airports first and flying to Le Plan. So the closest airport to Le Plan is Geneva Airport, and although it's in Switzerland, it means you are usually crossing over the border into Switzerland and then back into France to get here, but it's the most popular for a lot of reasons. It has the most regular flight schedule from the main airports around the UK, and also a lot of the regional airports as well, like covering Leeds, Birmingham, Bristol, Bournemouth, Southampton, and also the Irish airports as well. So definitely check it out. It has most of the cheap flights coming out of there as well, like EasyJet. Usually they are the cheapest flight options, although it's always worth checking out British Airways and France Air as well. There's also the ski transfers, so the actual, like, who is going to pick you up from the airport and bring you actually to the resort. And the ski transfers are the most regular in and out of Geneva Airport as well. So although you might find cheaper flights in some of the other airports, you might find that you haven't got the transfer options or availability to the other resorts as well. So that's just something to be aware of before you book and confirm your flights. Finally, if you're looking to rent a car to drive yourself from the airport to your ski holiday, then you will have a lot more options from Geneva Airport as well. And you can rent a car from the Swiss side of the airport and the French side of the airport as well. And there's a couple of differences there, but I won't go into that right now. You can find more of that information on my video about driving to your ski holiday. So that's Geneva Airport in a nutshell. The next one that I'm going to talk about is Grenoble Airport. So Grenoble is again about 3 to 3.5 hours away from Le Plan. It's a comparable time distance to Geneva, and it is in France. It's a much smaller airport than Geneva, so quite often people overlook it. But it is actually a good option if you are looking to come on your ski holiday. But one of the things to be aware of at Grenoble Airport is it, because it's a lot smaller, there's a lot less services there. So things like food and drink and amenities, duty free, well, it's not duty free anymore, is it? But food shopping and clothes shopping and things like that just doesn't really exist in the same way. And often the queues and things at Grenoble can be a lot longer because they just don't have the staffing and the more sophisticated services that you see at Geneva. And then the last airport I'm just going to mention is Lyon, which really gets overlooked and isn't kind of on a lot of people's radars. It's worth checking out because you can often find some really good flight deals and cheaper deals and things, but do be aware that the transfer companies really don't service Lyon Airport at all. So even if you're looking at booking a private transfer, it might be something that the transfer companies just aren't doing because they can't often sync up a pickup or a drop off in Lyon with another collection that they might have later in the day. So check your ski transfers before you book a flight into Lyon Airport. Lyon to Le Plan takes about 2.5 hours each way, and what I should say for all of the transfers to and from these airports, you're going to find that they all take longer in peak season because the roads are just so much busier with so many more people coming on holiday. Okay, so that's kind of the airports as well, the three top airports in the area. That's for La Plagne and also a lot of the other ski resorts in the Tarentais area. So just to run over those, you've got Val d'Isère, Tignes, La Rosière, Saint-Foix, and then La Plagne and Les Arcs. And then you've got the three valleys, so Mirabel, Courchevel, Val Thorens. They're all going to be covered by the kind of same information for those airports that I've talked about in regards to La Plagne. So if you are booking a flight, the next bit you're going to have to think about is your transfer. So I've said ski transfers, and this is who is picking you up from the airport and taking you to and from the airport to your ski accommodation and then back at the end of your holiday. So there's a couple of different options. You can book a private transfer, which is basically a private taxi or a private minibus up to 8 or 9 seats, which is just for you and your party, and you're not sharing that with anybody else. And then you've got shared transfers, where it could be a minibus of 8 that you're sharing with another family or another booking that people you don't know, or it might be a larger bus that's full of lots of different bookings and people arriving that you don't know. Or it could be a coach transfer, if it's a package holiday that you've booked with a big tour operator like Crystal Ski or Esprit, then odds are you've probably got a bus transfer included in your package holiday. The most popular option for people arriving is the private transfer. Something to be aware of is post-Brexit and post-COVID, the demand for private transfers has gone absolutely through the roof. And so if you are looking to book all these different elements of your ski holiday yourself, then this is something that you really need to look into and make sure that you can find availability, because they get booked out really quickly. And also, you might be quite surprised by how much it costs, because the price is not cheap. You can be looking up to, you know, 600 to 800 euros for return transfers for a group of 6, 7, 8 people. So don't be surprised by that. Just around this video, in the comments, I've included some recommendations for local transfer companies that I work with in La Plagne that are really awesome and have got excellent reputation. So you can definitely check them out. If you're looking for a shared transfer, then a couple of options for you. One that's called Alp to Alps, which is okay, and you've got Alpibus as well. And then the one that most people are kind of aware of is Ben's Bus, and they are really great. And they are, of course, a lot cheaper because they are coaches and they're filling up with lots and lots of people. But the thing to be aware of with those shared transfers is you can't choose the time of your transfer. So you are set on the time that they are going to be leaving the airport. So for example, your flight might arrive at 2 o'clock, but the next transfer might not be until 6 o'clock, but that's what you have to do. Whereas a private transfer, if your flight arrives at 2, they'll meet you at that time and away you go. So there's a bit more flexibility on that private transfer. Some top tips for your airport transfers. If you are traveling with children, then ask for your car seats. If you need booster seats or baby seats, then you definitely need to make sure you request those, because if they don't have them available, it might be something that you have to fly with. Save your driver's number before you take off, so that you can remain in contact with them just in case you have any delays or problems, questions or queries. And if the price that's quoted to you seems too good to be true, then it probably is. Okay, there are a lot, unfortunately, of unlicensed transfer companies out there at the moment taking advantage of people, and while the price might seem incredible, it's probably because it is incredible, and they will maybe not turn up to meet you at the airport when you arrive. So the last thing you want on your family ski holiday is to be stranded at Geneva Airport. Okay, so train travel, that's the next thing that we're going to have a look at. So whilst the snow train is no longer available, and the snow train was when you could book a train directly from St Pancras all the way down to the Tarentaise Valley in one long stop, that's no longer available, but you can book it as part of a holiday package. And so the holiday package is called the Travel Ski Express, and so they book package holidays, and they do have availability in La Plagne as well as several other resorts, so definitely have a look at that. They will be running from the 17th of December this year through to the 16th of April in 2024, so that's December 2023 to April 2024, so have a look at them. And whilst you can't book train travel or the snow train independently if you've booked your accommodation separately, what you can do is book connecting trains. So you can get the crossover into Paris, and then you would need to transfer through Paris and get the next train all the way down into the Tarentaise Valley. And this is completely doable, and it's not that difficult. So there's a couple of tips and things that you can follow to help you out with that train travel. Have a look at my train travel video for that one, rather than me going into detail to it here. But a couple of the main reasons why people travel by train to their ski holidays: it's more environmentally friendly than flying. So if you're really looking to have a more sustainable ski holiday, which is something that we should all be very conscious of, then train travel can be a really good option. It's more reliable often than flights. We're seeing a lot of delays through the airports. They're very impacted by weather, by strikes, by low staffing due to COVID and Brexit restrictions. So train travel can be more reliable. The quality of the French train system as well is pretty excellent. So the high speed train, the TGV, is really incredible, and it's quite amazing how fast you can cover the majority of France. If you are traveling with children, then it can be a much easier and less a more hassle-free option if you get onto the train and then you just stay on the train all the way through to your final destination. You don't have all the kind of passport queues and security checks and waiting around at airports, and so it can make travel and life just a lot easier with young children. And the last thing is luggage allowance. You have got a lot more space and a lot more luggage allowance when you are on the train, although my word to the wise would be the last thing you want to be doing through the airports is lugging massive amounts of suitcases and ski bags and boot bags and things. So although you have got a better luggage allowance, don't feel like you have to fill it. So there we go, that's the train travel. And then the last thing I'm just going to talk about is driving to La Plagne. And so it's been not so popular in the past driving from the UK to your French ski holiday, but in recent years it's become more and more popular as people look to do DIY ski holidays and travel or self-drive themselves to their ski holiday. So it can be a really great option, and although you wouldn't believe it, it can actually be faster and also sometimes cheaper than flying to resort. But you do need to be aware of your budgeting and things like the tunnel crossing or your ferry or fuel, how much fuel you're going to use, parking in resort, is that available, how much is it going to cost, and so on and so forth. So there's just a few things to think about, and again you can check out my video on driving to ski resorts to find out more about that in detail. If you are coming to La Plagne and you want to know more about the car parking around the resort, then you can check out some information on my blog. But basically there's a lot of free on the road car parking around La Plagne, which is quite different to a lot of other ski resorts that don't have it. And then there is some paid car parking which is underground, and it is quite limited in supply. So again, double check if that is something you want to get. My first tip would always be to check with your accommodation supplier, because quite often they have parking that they can rent to you first of off, because you are taking their accommodation, and if they can't, then they can probably recommend a space that you can find with the tourist information usually. If you're looking to drive an electric vehicle out to the Alps, you should know that this is getting easier and easier to do with lots of fast charge points throughout France, making the journey really, really quick and straightforward. If you come into La Plagne in an electric vehicle, we have less charging stations around the resort, although hopefully this will be improving in the future. So as of talking to you right now, which is summer 2023, there is one public fast charging point in the Boulevard car park, but there are charging points at other accommodations like the Hotel Carlina, for example. So do again check with your accommodations to see what is available for you. And then finally, I just wanted to run through some top tips if you're traveling with ski bags and snowboard bags, because they can be really bulky and really heavy. So here's the things that I would do. Firstly, if you can rent equipment once you get to resort, do it. There's absolutely no reason to be lugging shed loads of equipment and ski bags and things through the airport or on the train or strapping them to the top of your car. If you can rent stuff in resort, it's often a lot cheaper as well, and the hassle that it will save you is great. So definitely do that. If you are going to bring equipment with you, then prioritise boots. Hi, Odin. prioritise boots because they will make the biggest difference to the comfort and your quality of skiing once you get on your holiday. And when you're looking at getting bags, prioritise things like padding to keep your equipment safe and secure, wheels on your bag to help you move around more comfortably. You might need extra or more space than you think if you've got multiple pairs of skis or you want to pack all your family's equipment together. And just check with airlines now whether you need to book on your ski and snowboard bags in advance, and the same goes for your transfer companies. For example, if you're a party of eight getting a private transfer, are you going to have eight pairs of skis as well? Most ski transfer companies are set up for this, but it is a good idea to just make sure that they're aware of that, and that they have got the space for you to get all your rear equipment onto the train, onto the transfer. If you want to save space when you're carrying all your equipment, you can't really take your bindings off of your skis. It's probably going to cause more damage than it is going to help you save space. But for your snowboard equipment, it can save you quite a bit of space, and it's a lot easier to just take your snowboard bindings off of the boards and then you can stack everything quite flat. So that's something that I would recommend looking at doing. And that's it from me. So we've talked about La Plagne and the nearest airports, how to get to and from the airports to the ski resorts. Then we've also talked about train travel and why it can be a good option. And then we just wrapped up looking at all the things to consider if you're going to be driving to resort. That's a really brief overview of the different ways that you can travel to your ski holidays. All of the different things that I've mentioned, I go into in much more detail in different videos, which you'll find linked from this place here, just down in the comments. And if you've got any questions or anything you'd like to know more about, just hit me up and I will get back to you as soon as possible. And this has been Jen. I hope you found this video useful. And if you have, just like and subscribe to the channel to see more content like this. Take care and I'll see you on the slopes.